Good evening, church. Shalom. Praise God for the new day and night that He is allowing us to stay alive in all these situations. We praise God and we thank Him for all His blessing that He is giving to us. So tonight we are going to share the Word of God. But before we start sharing the Word of God, let us put ourselves in the presence of the Lord and ask the guidance of the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Father God, Abba Sheva Shevaim, good evening, Abba Father, good evening, Lord Yeshua HaMashiach, good evening, Holy Spirit. I declare and I decree that you are my Father and I am your child. You are my Master and I am your servant. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray that you will be taking over my mind, taking over my heart, taking over my feelings. And I pray that you will be using me in order to deliver the message that you want us to hear it. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray that you will be anointing my mind, anointing my heart, anointing my eyes, anointing my lips, anointing every single beat of my heart that is coming to be dedicated for you and to be used for your own glory. Father, in the name of Jesus, I humble myself to you and I ask you forgiveness for all my sins that I did it, the sins that I'm aware about it, or the sins that I did it unintentionally. Father, forgive me for my sin. I humble myself for you and I ask you, Lord, to take over and let your Holy Spirit be manifested in this night, so we will be hearing your word, Father, in the name of Jesus. And I pray for all the hearts that you already prepared, all the minds that you wanted to believe in you and to come back to your feet. I pray that they are already set and they are already waiting for your word to enter their heart and their mind, so they will come to you and they will come to know you, the true living God, Yeshua HaMashiach, the Jewish Messiah, that he was already prophesied about it and he already came and destroyed the evil world. Father, in the name of the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach, we thank you, we praise you, we give you back all the glory, all the honor, all the highest adoration, and we declare and we decree that we love you, Abba Father, we love you, Lord Yeshua HaMashiach, and we love you, Holy Spirit, and we ask you, Lord, in the name of Jesus, and we rebuke all the evil spirit, all the deceiving spirits, all the unnecessary spirits that will try to take away our focus from you and take away our eyes from you, not to hear your voice or not to accept your word. Father, I rebuke and I refuse all the deceiving spirits, and I bind it in the mighty name of the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach. I declare and I decree that all the deceiving spirits are already paralyzed and they are inoperative in the mighty name of the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach, and only the Holy Spirit is moving around and is touching the heart and the mind for us to be closer and closer to you and to strengthen our relation with you. In the mighty name of the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach, I pray. Amen. Amen. Good evening, church. So tonight we are going to share the word of God about our relation with Jesus. Amen. So the Bible verse is taken from the book of Matthew 16:24. Holy Spirit, bless your holy word. Then Jesus said to his disciple, if anyone wants to come after me, he must deny himself, take up his cross and follow me. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory be to the word of God. So if you can see here in the Bible verse, it's very clear what Jesus said. If anyone wants to come after me. So Jesus, he is our God. He loves us so much. Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus, the true living God, he loves us so much. And he is so patient and respectful to our will. He never obliges anyone. He never forces. He allows things to happen in our life to give us hints on what decision we have to take, or which way we have to follow, or what we must say. He is omniscient, our God. I'm talking about our God, that he is omniscient, he is omnipotent, and he is omnipresent. Omniscient, I mean that he knows everything. Omnipotent, it means that he can do everything, nothing is impossible for him. And omnipresent, he is everywhere. Amen. Glory to the Jesus. So nothing can be hidden from God. Nothing can be hidden from him. And every sin we commit, it will be written in the book of remembrance, and we will be judged accordingly. until the day we confess it and repent it. So all the sins that we are doing, it is written in the book of remembers, and it will not be removed until we confess it and we repent on it. Amen. So if we remember, His love is great for us, and if we look back to our life before we surrender our life to the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach, and we remember how we were acting, talking, behaving, you will see that it is totally different from our current situation now and current life and current attitude. Amen? So after we surrender our life to the true living God, Yeshua HaMashiach, and becoming born again, our attitude totally changed. Our way of thinking is changed. Our way of accepting the things also is changed. So everything will be changed. We are new. We are born again. We are like created as a new one. Amen? So since we are born again, we have a bigger responsibility than the unbeliever, as we already know the truth and experience the true love and the true peace and joy. And we must also transfer it to each person who is not yet surrendered to Jesus, or he does not even know Jesus. Amen? So we must be an example. We must lead by example, by having a honest and transparent relationship with our Lord Yeshua HaMashiach. And we must make him the center of every aspect of our life. If we want to be prosperous, or we want to be successful in our life. If we remember in Joshua 1:8, Holy Spirit bless your holy word. This book of law shall not depart from your mouth, but you shall meditate on it day and night, so that you may be careful to do according to all that is written in it. For then you will make your way prosperous, and then you will achieve success. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus. So church, it's very clear and it's very straightforward from our Lord Yeshua HaMashiach. Once we have our relation with him, once we are born again, once we accept Jesus as our Lord and Savior, and we are following the path, the way that Jesus wants us to follow, it will be our responsibility as well to share him and to be an example and leading by example for the others on how to build a strong relation with the true living God, so the other people can see the difference. Because if the other people will see us as well acting the same what they are acting, and talking the same what they are talking, and behaving the same behavior that they are doing it, then there is no difference between us and them. And Jesus told us that we are the salt of the earth. We are the light that the people need to see it. So when they will see the light, they will glorify our Father. They will not glorify us. They will not give us, they will not praise us. We will give all the glory for him. So this is the main purpose of being in a relation with the true living God, Yeshua HaMashiach, is to always give glory to him. Always holding him as the torch, as the light that he will be enlightening the life of the other people. Amen? So every person who is looking to be prosperous and successful, he must read and meditate in the Bible, in the Word of God as a whole, and not only choosing specific passage. It must be continuous and daily. Put time to read Bible and meditate in the Word, and ask the discernment of the Holy Spirit, that he is the best teacher to give us the spirits of knowledge, the spirits of understanding, so we can understand what is the message from the Lord that we need to do. Amen? So, in order to be prosperous, we should always read the Bible. We should always meditate in the Word of God, and we should always put time to spend time with the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach in reading the Bible. So, every time we are reading the Bible, we also must ask the guidance of the Holy Spirit. Because without the guidance of the Holy Spirit, without the discernment, the discernment spirit, the spirits of knowledge, the spirits of understanding that's coming from the Holy Spirit, we cannot understand what is the perfect will of our Lord Yeshua HaMashiach. Amen? We are in a relation. As you know, church, Every person that he is in a relation with any other person, he must spend time with him. He talk to him, and then the other person speak also to you. So it's a relation. It's type of communication, and the communication, it's a two-way communication. Amen. So we will move forward, and then we will see. We will talk more about this in our normal life. So the first point, church, is building a relation with Yeshua. What is, how to build a relation with Yeshua? In our normal life, if we like someone and we want to have a relation with him, okay, first of all, what we do, we accept the other person as it is. We don't complain about him. We don't start to pinpoint, why your hair color is like that? Why your eye color is like that? Or we accept him as it is. Khalas, we know that this person, we want to have a relation with him. We don't be picky with him. We just accept him as it is, and we will start to set time to go out together, to have coffee, to enjoy, to talk the same topics that is interesting for both of us. So this is how we start our relation with a normal person. Then, for our Lord Yeshua HaMashiach, it's the same procedures. Amen. So we also first have to accept him as our Lord and Savior, same as we accept the other person. And second is to spend time with him and talk with him about the common subject, which is our salvation. Amen. He loves us, and we once we accept him, once we want to build the relation with him, we are saying that we also accept his love, so we want also to share the same love that he is giving to us. Amen. So when we are going into relation with our Lord Yeshua HaMashiach, first step is to accept him as Lord and Savior in our life. Amen. And this is, church, this is the main point that the evil one is trying to make us deceived by it and try to blind our eyes. How? For example, a lot of people like they are born in a religion. Amen. Like, and it might be in Christian religion or any other religion. So when these people are born in this religion, you know, they don't accept boldly. They don't say it. They don't say that we accept Lord Yeshua HaMashiach as our Lord and Savior. So the evil one, what he is doing, he's putting in their mind that, yes, you are okay, you are fine, you are saved, you know Jesus, you know everything, but actually you don't know anything. Amen? Actually, how you can say that you know Jesus if you are not reading the Bible? How you can say that you accept Jesus if you don't say it boldly and in an audible voice? How you can say that I am born again if you are not undergoing the water baptism? Amen? So it is all a deceiving things from the evil one. Now, another issue will be risen. The other person, he might argue with you and he will tell you, no, when I was small, I undergo the water baptism and I am saved now. Then, okay, fine. If you are saved now and you are you went under the water baptism, where is your will in the whole thing? Amen? We just say that if someone wants to follow Jesus, we said in Matthew, if someone wants to follow Jesus, he must deny himself. If, we are saying if we want. So it is our will, and God, he respects our will, and God respects us. Amen? So if we said, if you are saying that, yes, we are saved and we already undergo the water baptism and everything, if all right, where is our will? Ask yourself. You must ask the other person who is that much resistant to undergo the water baptism or to accept boldly the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach. We should willingly going to the Lord and accept him. And this is the only way where we will be having the power and the authority, where the Holy Spirit will grant us the authority to stand firm and to rebuke the evil one. Or else we are weak, we are defeated. Amen? But we are victorious. Why? Because we accepted the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach as our Lord and Savior on our life. Plus, we undergo the water baptism, so we receive the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. So do not be deceived, church. Always remember that our will is the most important factor in our relation with the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach. Nobody is obliging us. Nobody forced us. Nobody put the gun in our head and told us, no, you have to have a relation with the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach. We choose this one. If we choose this one, then we have to bear responsibility of our choices. Amen. So to come back to our points, the same procedures needs to be followed to start a relation with our true living God. First, we must accept Him as Lord and Savior in our life. Second, we start to set time to pray for Him. This is how we talk to Him, and this is like the sender, because in the communication we have sender and we have receiver. So when we talk to the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach, we send a message. And third, we read continuously our Bible, and this is how the Lord speaks to us, and this is where we are the receiver. Amen? So sender and receiver, we send the message for the Lord through our prayer, we receive the message from the Lord through the reading the Bible. Amen? So we cannot consider ourselves in a true relation with God if we are missing any of these steps. The devil is a liar, and he is trying hard to deceive us by convincing us that if we are born in a specific religion, we must stay in it and never change. And this is also another point. Because some people, when you are sharing the word of God with them, what they will tell you, if God wants me to be in what you are saying, then He will be making me born in this concept. Like, for example, if we are sharing to any other person who is from different religion, for Buddhist or for another religion, Christian, he will tell you, no, if God wants me to be a born again, then He will make me born in a born again family. This is a lie. This is a lie from the evil to make us, to keep us stubborn and to keep us in lazy and to keep us not to look into the true living God. Amen. Let us be awake of the truth, and let us be alerted that the devil is working very hard in the small detail in order to make us deceived, in order to remove our eyes from the true living God, Yeshua HaMashiach. Amen. And it is our responsibility as the children of God is to enlighten or to highlight and to pinpoint on what the evil one is doing for each one of them. We should be first filled with the love of God, so whenever we are talking to them, they can feel this love. Because if we don't have the love of God inside us, we cannot give. If somebody asked me to give him 10 dirham and I don't have 10 dirham, how can I give him? If I'm going and trying to share the love of God, I should possess the love of God in my mind, in my heart, in my spirit, deep inside my whole, so it can overflow. And this is the importance. That's why it's very important to spend time with God, because every time we set time with God, we will be like filled with the Spirit, filled with the Word, filled with the truth, filled with this fire that is inside us. And this fire should be saved inside our soul, inside our spirit, inside us. So whenever is the time that God wants us to share it with the other, He will get the Holy Spirit inside us to move, and everything will be moving accordingly. Amen? And the other person can feel it. But the most important thing is us. Our will to be ready to come, to empty ourselves, to make ourselves empty from all the worldly thing. If we are filled by the love of money, by the love of flesh, by the desire of the flesh, if we are filled by the talk, unnecessary talk, by gossiping, by doing unhealthy things, we are filled. How come the Holy Spirit will come and fill with us? Even as we are coming to the Lord, we should empty ourselves. We should remove everything from ourselves. Lord, empty me from myself and come and take over. Amen? So this is very important, church, in our relation with the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach, to be aware about it and to prepare. This is the preparation that we have to be ready for. Or else we cannot share. If we don't possess the love of God, we cannot share the love of God. If we don't possess the relation, if we don't have the proper relation with the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach, the other person will not be able to convince, to be convinced that that Yeshua HaMashiach is the true living God. Amen? So it is very important, and it is very, very, how do we say it? It is a very delicate matter that we need to handle with extreme care. Amen? So, glory to Jesus. So, what we said, that we cannot consider ourselves in a true relation with God if we are missing any of the of this step. It means that accepting Him as a Lord and Savior and spending time with Him by reading the Bible and praying to Him. Because the devil is a liar and is trying hard to deceive us by convincing us that if we are born in a specific religion, we must stay in it and never change. The deceiving spirit will be telling to our mind, if God wants you to be in other religion, He will make you born in different religion. That's what I just shared. And this is the tactic of Satan to keep us following religious or the religion that will never save us. Amen? Religion will never save us. Only by the name of the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach, by accepting Him as a Lord and Savior, and by confessing Him that He is the Lord and He is the true living God, we will be saved. Let it be known for all of us, for everyone, that this is the truth. And this is what we have to always testify. Amen? And so, the religion will never save us. And keep, and it will always keep us away from the relation which will save us by grace if we believe in the true living God, Yeshua HaMashiach. Amen. Glory to Jesus. Our salvation is only granted once we are having a true and honest relationship with the true living God, Yeshua HaMashiach. As there is no other name on earth can save except His name. Acts 4:12, Holy Spirit, bless your holy word. And there is salvation in no one else, for there is no other name under heaven that has been given among mankind by which we must be saved. Amen. So the truth is the truth. So blessed is who he will believe in that and accept the Lord before it's too late, as our God is the only way. John 14:6, Holy Spirit, bless your holy word. Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. Some other religion believe only in the Father. Some other people, they don't believe even in God. They believe in status. They believe in just spirits, or they believe in anything. This is all deceiving from the evil one to make us away from the truth. Amen. We must be bold enough to share it. However, we don't force and we don't put the other person that he is in a wrong way. We always have to remember ourselves when we were far from Jesus, how Jesus bring us to his feet. How he bring us to his feet? By love, not by force, not by highlighting on our mistakes, not by putting anything. He was allowing all the situation to happen in our life in order to see his love. So this is the message that we have to follow it. And this is the example that we have to follow it, is to love the other and show him the love of God. And in order to love the other and show him the love of God, we must have a relation with him. Amen? So that's the most important point, and that's where all our topics is talking about. Our relation with the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach is the most important thing for to be able to be filled with the love of God and to be able to share the love of God for the other. Amen? Because only by the love of God, we can bring the other person for the feet of the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach. If we think that we are just smart enough, or we can talk in a way that we bring the other person for the feet of the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach, allow me to tell you, church, it's not true. It's not true. This is also deceiving. Why? Because this is pride. This is, we are showing we are doing the things. We are nothing. Greater is he that he is in me, that he is in the world. So he must be glorified, not us. Everything that will be glorifying us, it's not from God. Everything that glorify God, it's for Him, because for Him is all the glory. Amen, amen, and amen. So, it's every person who believe in this and accepted, he is blessed, because Jesus said in 14:6, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one come to the Father except through me. After accepting the true living God as Lord and Savior, we must follow His steps and do so, and do what Jesus was doing. And what is that? Or following what Jesus was instructing. What is that? In Matthew 16:24, the first four. If then Jesus said to His disciple, if anyone wants to come after me, he must deny himself, take up his cross, and follow me. Amen. And this is the message for us as the children of God who accepted Lord, who accepted Yeshua HaMashiach as our Lord and Savior, that we need to deny ourselves. Amen. Nothing for ourselves. Nothing for Elias. Elias is nothing. He is only the compartment. He is only the mirror that reflect the glory of the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach. Because at the end of the day, it's not me who is living. The spirits who is inside me is living. Amen. Once I surrender my life to Jesus, it's not me who live anymore. Only Him who is inside me, He is living. And in order for Him to live. In a healthy and in a prosperous way, we must nourish Him. Amen. It's like the body. The body, to be healthy and to be balanced, we must eat proper food, exact amount, and to drink and to sleep and to take care of Him. The same for our spirit. In order to have a spiritual health, a spiritual life, we must spend proper time, proper amount, talk to the Lord, and nourish our spirit from the Word of God. Amen. So, second point is the cross. The cross during the time of Yeshua was a curse and sign of humility. But the Lord used it as tool to redeem us. Amen. In Galatians 3:13, Holy Spirit bless your holy word. Christ redeemed us from the curse of the law, having become a curse for us. For it is written, curse is everyone who is hanged on a tree. Amen. So, the main purpose of Yeshua coming from the bottom of God, the Father, is to destroy the work of the evil. It's written in 1 John 3:8, Holy Spirit, bless your holy word. The one who practices sin is the devil, for the devil has been sinning from the beginning. The Son of God appeared for this purpose, to destroy the work of the devil. Amen. As a result of destroying the evil work, we will inherit the salvation if we believe in His name, or else we are judged. How we know how I'm talking like this? In John 3:18, Holy Spirit, bless your holy word. The one who believes in Him is not judged. The one who does not believe has been judged already, because he has not believed in the name of the only Son of God. Amen. All glory to Jesus. This word is so powerful, and this word is so strong. Every person who is really desiring to know the true living God, he will be shaken when he will be reading this word. It's really amazing. Our God is so strong and so powerful. Imagine everything is already set. Everything is already said by our Lord. And this is a true example that what we are following is the truth, because nothing is contradicting. Everything is clear. Everything that was set from the beginning, it's coming into pass, and everything that was prophesied is coming into pass, and everything that we are waiting to be done, it will happen. Amen. The history prove it. Our relation proof it. The Spirit, when we receive the Holy Spirit, it's also another proof. When we share it with the other people, it's proof. The life and the testimony of the other people that they are sharing the same what we are sharing now, it's a proof. All it's a proof that Yeshua HaMashiach is the true living God, and only by accepting Him as the Lord and Savior and having a relation with Him, we can be saved. Amen. None of the religion, none of the any other teaching, none of any other beliefs with any other God, with the small g, not the capital G. Amen. So that's the truth, and that's what we always have to hold on and be for. Our God is the truth, and He never lies. If He said this word, mean He is the truth. Whoever who will accept, he will benefit himself and will be saved. When Yeshua is coming back again, he will be saved when Yeshua is coming back again. And whoever he is not accepting this word and refusing to have a relation with the true living God, Yeshua HaMashiach, he will bear his consequences of his choice. Amen? So for every person who accepted already Yeshua HaMashiach as Lord and Savior and is a born again, who is following Jesus, must deny himself, take his cross and follow Jesus. And whoever still not yet surrendered to the true living God must do this without fail, so he will be able to enter in the new Jerusalem. Amen? So, for us as a believer, as the people who know the true living God, we must follow what Jesus said. Deny ourselves and hold our cross. And for the other people who did not yet surrender for Jesus, they should accept him as Lord and Savior as a first step, and then later on they should follow they should undergo the water baptism and start their relation with the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach, because this is the only way that we can be saved. Amen. Third point, denying ourselves. The evil is like a roaring lion who wants to devour us. Every child of God must not forget that we are in a spiritual war on a daily basis. Ephesians 6:12, Holy Spirit, bless your holy word, for our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the powers, against the world forces of this darkness, against the spiritual forces of wickedness in the heavenly places. Amen? So our war is not against a person, it's not against a physical person that we can just beat him on his face and he's done. It is against the rulers, against the powers, against the world forces of this darkness, against the spiritual forces of wickedness in the heavenly places. Amen? Imagine how strong he is, but we have a stronger and mightier and bigger God that he already destroyed him. Yani, If we put it in a logic, how big he is and how strong, see? He is the power against the world of forces, the darkness against the spiritual forces, all the wickedness of the heavenly places. All this big that we can see, our God destroy it. Amen? So it's already defeated. If we belong to the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach, if we have the relation with the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach, it means in our feet we already crushed the devil under our feet. Amen. Hallelujah. All glory to Jesus. So we shouldn't underestimate ourselves as a children of God. As a children of God, as a people who has a relation, we must have the power and the authority that God already destroyed your evil. You cannot come over, you cannot touch my life. You cannot interfere in my life. The blood of the Lord is already purchased. I am purchased by the blood of the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach. I belong to the Lord. It's very simple, church. If I go to the supermarket, I see one bread, for example. I take the bread. It will not be mine unless I pay for it. Amen? So once I pay for it, I purchase it, it is mine. Nobody can snatch it for me unless I will give it by my own. Amen. The evil one might try to steal it from me, but it's for me. I will follow him and I will get it. And if I will call the police, for example, to get it, it will be mine. Because why? Because I have the proof, I have the receipt that I already purchased this item. This item belonged to me. So if we are the children of God, we are already purchased by the most precious price, which is the blood of the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach. So if the evil one come and try to snatch us, we will tell him, no, we don't belong to you, we belong to the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach. And to be able to stand firm and tell him that we don't belong to you, we must build a relation with the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus. This is the important things why we should be in a relation in our true living God, not in a religion. Religion is following step 1, step 2, step 3, step 4. But religion will not save you. Only the relation will save you. You will not be able to understand what is in the Bible. You will not be able to understand what is going on in your life. What you will not be able to have the discernment what's happening within you unless you have the relation with the true living God, Yeshua HaMashiach. Why? Because once you have the relation with the true living God, Yeshua HaMashiach, and once you accept Him as Lord and Savior, you undergo the water baptism, you will be receiving the gift of the Holy Spirit. And this gift of the Holy Spirit, which is also God, which is also from God, the Spirit of God within us, it will be teaching us everything. And everything will be clear in our mind, in our heart, in our life, in our relations, in every single aspect in our life. The Lord Yeshua HaMashiach will take over. The Holy Spirit will take over. You will be like the fire that is coming from the Lord. And this is what the Lord wants us, even to be on fire or to be on cold. If we are on fire, we will benefit. We will be benefit. Why? Because we will. This fire will burn all the evil things that is still remaining in us, and the evil one will not be able to approach us because we are in fire of the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach. Amen. So let us really give importance to the relation of our Lord Yeshua HaMashiach, and not to be stuck with the religion, and not to be deceived by whatever everybody is following. Amen. So to be able to stand firm against all the evil war, we must first equip ourselves with the full armor of God. Please refer to Ephesians 6:10-18 to read the full armor of God. The helmet of salvation, the breastplate of righteousness, the belt of truth, the shield of faith, sword of the spirit, sandal gospel of peace, and the prayers and with the prayers and supplication of the saints. So all this full armor of God, we should wear it appropriately on a daily basis. And second, we should humble ourselves before the Lord, empty ourselves from our pride, from our ego, and we should command our angels to capture all the deceiving spirits that's trying to take away our heart and eyes from the true living God, Yeshua HaMashiach, and who is trying to be the obstacle in order to create the relation with our Lord and Savior, Yeshua HaMashiach. Amen. So, church, we cannot defeat the enemy by our own strengths. We must always remember that this is the Lord war. This is the word for the Lord. Amen. Jesus said, this is my word. This is my war. He said to be still. The Lord is fighting for you. Exodus 14:14. Amen. So we have to be still. We only need to be still. Still, it means not like standing, doing nothing. Be still, it means we have to be in peace. And to be in peace, we have to go to the Prince of Peace. Who is the Prince of Peace? Is Yeshua HaMashiach. And to come to the Prince of Peace, it means that we are building a relation with Him. Amen. So it's very important to have the relation. So the war is not ours. It's the Lord, and we must allow the Lord to fight for us and be assured that we are victorious. 1 John 4:4, Holy Spirit, bless your holy word. You are from God, little children, and have overcome them, because greater is He who is in you than he who is in the world. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus. I praise you, Lord. I praise you, Lord. It's amazing. It's amazing, church. How beautiful is our God. Imagine, you are from God, little children. He knows that we are the little children of the Lord. And overcome the world. Because greater, why? Because greater is He, it means the Lord, greater is He who is in us than He is in the world. Amen? So by denying ourselves, We will be overcoming because of Him, because of the Lord, and not because of me, and not because of the I, not because of the pride, or not because I am smart, or I am good looking, or belong to a rich family, or I have a high position, or I have an authority, or anything. Never like that. Only by the name of the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach, we will get the victory. Amen. And only by the name of the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach we are saved. Because greater is He who is in us than He who is in the world. All glory to the true living God, Yeshua HaMashiach. We must also deny ourselves. Why? Because Yeshua, by denying Himself, He was first an example for us, a leader for us, and He was able to accomplish the will of God the Father in destroying the evil work as the evil thought. Amen. The evil thought that he can finish the what Yeshua is doing, what the Lord is doing on earth by killing Him, by putting Him on the cross, by nailing Him on the cross. But He was shocked. The evil one was shocked after the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach gave up His spirit. Because when He gave up His spirit, He went to the Hades and He break all the things. He break every chain and everything was destroyed. Amen. So he thought that by killing Him on the cross, finish, it's done. No more disturbance. However, by Yeshua HaMashiach denying Himself and being crucified on the cross, what happened in Matthew 27:50-51? And Jesus cried out again with a loud voice and gave up His spirit. And behold, the veil of the temple was torn into two from top to bottom. And the earth shook and the rock were split. Amen. So the veil of the temple represents the separation between the holy place and the most holy place. So that this veil had been broken, has been torn. Amen. So no more separation. No more. Yeshua HaMashiach, by His death, He opened a direct way. He opened a highway between us and the Lord and God the Father. Amen. So He opened the way so we can have the relation. That's the most important things also to understand, that before, as God said, that the law had been given by Moses, but the truth had been given by the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach. Amen. So we get the law by Moses. We get the what to do, what to follow, and how we have to deal with God the Father by Moses, by the truth. But the truth had been given by the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach. Amen. When He came and He was preaching and He was declaring the kingdom of heaven. Amen. So Yeshua, He gave us His spirit. He laid down His life and the veil was torn. So no more separation, no more obstacle. Nothing can put us away from having the relation, the direct relation. If we have the opportunity to have a direct relation, why do we have to go through processes? Why we have to go through following step 1, step 2, step 3, step 4? Amen? All the law had been given already. Now everything is broken. And this is like the physical action that happened to show us and to give a hint to our physical mind that no more separation between the holy place and the most holy place. Holy place is us, and the most holy place is where God is fine because of the tomb and because of what they had, Moses, the stick of Moses and the sample of manna and the most holy place, this tomb of God. So excuse me, church. So this is a clear message for us in the Bible on the importance of following the relation with the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach and not following the religion, because the religion is already broken. The veil is already torn. Amen. So we are living in the end time. The coming of the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach is right at the corner. All the prophecies are coming into pass, and tribulation can start at any time. Amen? As a child of God, we must not take it lightly and must always remember every time. As a child of God, we must not take it lightly and must always remember what Jesus advised us in Matthew 24:42. Holy Spirit, bless your holy word. Therefore, be on alert, for you don't know which day your Lord is coming. Amen. It is the alert and the sound alarm for us, for whoever he still not yet surrendered his life to the true living God. And whoever who doesn't have a personal relation with him, please, it is very important for you guys to be alerted and really take it seriously, because we are really in the end time, and Yeshua is coming. In all the religion and everywhere, everybody believes that Yeshua is coming. This is another question, church. Listen, this is another question as well to ask ourselves. If everybody believes that Yeshua will be coming back, why you don't believe in him that he is a true living God? He is able to change your life. Amen? So if you believe that he is going to come back, it means that this is truth. That why he has to come back and not other God or not other person or not any other, you name it. Amen? He is going to come back. So it is the truth. We must believe in him, accept him, have a relation with him before it's too late. Whoever who is listening now to the message and was really touched in his heart and feel convicted, and he really wants to have a relation with the true living God, please do not harden your heart and do not resist what is moving inside you and what is coming into your mind. Nothing happened by chance and nothing by coincidence. Our God is a planning God. He planned everything and he make everything happen according to the proper time. He has time for everything. So if you now feel that you are convicted and you want to surrender your life to Jesus, never resist or never harden your heart. Listen to the voice and follow me with this prayer in an audible voice. Say it loudly. Amen. Follow me with the prayer. Father God in heaven, thank you for your love. Thank you for your mercy. Thank you for waiting on me. Forgive me, Lord Jesus, for refusing to accept you. Forgive me for being resistant to your word. I admit my fault. Have mercy on me, the sinner. From this moment onward, I turn my back to my previous life. I refuse to live again the same way. I now declare that you are Jesus Christ of Nazareth, the Jewish Messiah. You are the true living God. I believe in you, Lord, and I believe that you came on earth, shed your blood on Calvary Cross, was put in a tomb, and God raised you again on the third day. I accept you, Lord Yeshua HaMashiach, as my Lord and personal Savior. And I ask you to come and take over my life. Lead me to the path of righteousness and help me to have a close relationship with you. So when you come back, I will be having a place in the New Jerusalem. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. So, conclusion, our God is so loving and merciful. He wants everyone to be saved and to come to know the truth. That's why he is using us to share his word and to enlighten the world on what is to come. We are blessed that we already know the truth and we have the relation with him. However, this relation must not be taken for granted, and we must make it deeper and deeper by always praying and reading the Bible daily and without ceasing. So we will be able to be filled with his power, discernment, and wisdom to stand firm against the trial that will face us when the tribulation starts. We must not forget what Jesus told us in Matthew 24:9. Then they will hand you over to tribulation and kill you, and you will be hated by all nations because of my name. It's not a joke. God never lies. We will be hated and we will be killed because of his name. So if we don't possess a deep relation with him, we will easily deny him, and by denying him we will lose our salvation and we will be thrown in the lake of fire. And this is what the evil one want and he's trying to do. Yeshua HaMashiach already destroyed the evil work and accomplished the will of God the Father. He offers the salvation to everyone, and He is waiting for us to accept Him and to have a relation with Him. I am not forcing, I am not pushing anyone to have a relation with the true living God, Yeshua HaMashiach. Neither Yeshua did when He was preaching about the kingdom of heaven. However, the truth remained the truth, even no one believed in it, and the lies is always a lie, even everyone accepted. In John 14:6, Holy Spirit, bless your holy word, Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one's come to the Father except through me. And in John 3:8, Holy Spirit, bless your holy word, the one who believes in him is not judged. The one who does not believe had been judged already, because he has not believed in the name of the only Son of God. Amen. We are free to choose. However, before taking any decision, think wisely and remember that only you will be bearing the consequences of your choices. Amen. All glory belongs to the Lord, Yeshua HaMashiach. Thank you for watching. God bless you all. Let us pray. let us pray closing prayers. I'm sorry, church. This is a clear proof that the evil one, he doesn't like what I'm talking. He's trying to disturb. I rebuke you in Jesus' name. So, hallelujah, all glory to Jesus. All glory belongs to our Lord Yeshua HaMashiach. Let us pray and thanks our Lord. Father God, Abba Sheba Shebaim, we thank you, Lord Jesus, for your word. We thank you for always reminding us. We thank you for loving us. And we thank you for allowing this relation with us to happen. We thank you for bringing us to you. We thank you for choosing us as your congregation, as your children. We thank you for all the blessing, the blessing that you are giving to us. Father, in the name of the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach, we bring you back all the glory, all the highest adoration. And we declare and we decree that you are the true living God, Yeshua HaMashiach, the Jewish Messiah, that he came to earth and destroyed the evil work and gave us the salvation. And we are saved by believing in you and by having a true relation with you. Father, I thank you for all the hearts that you already touched and all the souls that you already bring to your feet. I thank you, Lord, for giving us the boldness in order to share you. I thank you for letting your Holy Spirit be manifested and showing how great you are and how love you are and how strong you are and how mighty you are. All glory belong to you, Lord Jesus. We praise you, we honor you, we give you back all the glory. And we thank you all also, Lord, for reminding us that the cross, it's not a sign of curse anymore. The cross, it's not a sign of humility anymore. It's a sign of victory because of the cross, because you was hanged on a tree, because you was nailed. We received the salvation, and because of your precious blood that was shed on this tree, we are now cleansed and we are clean, and we have the power and we have the authority to be called your children because we believe in your Son, the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach. Father, we thank you, we praise you, we give you back all the glory. We declare that we love you, Abba Father. We love you, Lord Yeshua HaMashiach. We love you, Holy Spirit. In the mighty name of the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach, I pray. And I sealed my prayer by the precious blood of the Lord Yeshua HaMashiach. Amen, amen, and amen. Thank you so much, church, for watching. God bless you all. And stay tuned for the response song. God bless you.